Hello, everybody. It's Pastor Krueger. Welcome to chapel this week as we gather together to listen to our God's word, to sing songs of praise to him, and to focus in on our fruit of the Spirit for this week, which is self-control. We learned this week that self-control is when Christ's love compels us to resist temptation. And what we're going to see in our lesson today is that it's so much easier to resist those temptations when we have a life that is rooted in God's word. But first, friends, let's begin our worship today by calling on God's name and asking him to be with us. We worship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Friends, let's confess our sins together before God and ask him to forgive us. Father, I am sorry, for I have sinned against you. I have sinned against my parents and my teachers and my friends. I have done things that are wrong, and I have failed to do good things. I'm sorry, Father. Please forgive me. Amen. Friends, when we come to God like that and we tell him that we're sorry, that's a part of our self-control, controlling ourselves to admit our sin and to ask God for forgiveness. And it's not always easy to do, but here's the good news. When we come to God and we confess our sins like that, he forgives us. He forgives us every single one of our sins. And he does that because of Jesus, because Jesus came into this world and he lived and died for you. He lived a perfect life for you, and he died on the cross to take away your sins. So friends, I can tell you right now that your sins are forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ, your Savior. Amen. Let's go ahead and join together then in the joy of our forgiveness. We join together in singing a song. It's called, Lord, I Lift Your Name on High.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Friends, the Bible passage that our devotion is based on this week as we think about self-control comes from Psalm 119. Now, Psalm 119 is a really cool part of the Bible. It's a song from the Old Testament, a really long song that's just all about God's Word. Psalm 119 is 176 verses long. And every single one of those verses has something to tell us about God's Word. Today I want to focus in with you on just a little part right towards the beginning of that song in Psalm 119 verses 9 through 16. Right from the start, the songwriter asks a question. He asks this, he says, "How can a young person stay on the path of purity?" In other words, how can a young person, a child like you, live in a way that's pleasing in God's sight? Now, when I saw that question in our lesson, it reminded me of one of our three identity questions that we always look at. Our third identity question is very similar to this. We ask, how can you live for Jesus? And our answer to that question is that with the power and forgiveness of Jesus, I can be a leader by serving God and others. Psalm 119's answer is by living according to God's word. I can live for Jesus. I can stay on the path of purity. And now those two answers aren't really all that different, because it's God's word that gives us the power and the forgiveness of Jesus that we live by. And it's in God's word that Jesus tells us how he wants us to live, and that he wants us to be servant leaders who serve not only him, not only God, but the people around us in our lives too. And so the question we want to ask ourselves today is, how can I live according to God's word? How is it that we fill our lives with God's word? And our Bible passage here today gives us some excellent advice. First, it says we have to seek God in his word with all of our hearts. In verse 12, the author of this psalm praises God and he asks him, "Lord, teach me your decrees. Help me to learn what it is that you have to say." A decree is something that a ruler, like a king, would announce to his nation. And so what he's saying here, "teach me your decrees," that would include both the things that God commands of us, his law, the things he tells us to do, but also the things that he decrees to us, that he announces to us, the good things that he's done for us, the message of the gospel, that he sent a savior to rescue us from sin. Then as we seek out his decrees and as we try to learn them, in verse 16, the author says, "I delight in them. I delight in your decrees. I delight in the things that you have to say. I rejoice in them. And so I will not neglect your word," he says. "I won't ignore it." What does that look like for you and for me, friends, not to ignore God's word? To seek it out and to learn from it so that we can rejoice and delight in it. Well, it means that we're studying and reading or listening to the Bible. So let me ask you this question. And it's a great question for our students. It's a great question for our teachers and really for any moms and dads who are listening too. Is studying the Bible something that you guys do at home? Is it something that's a part of every single day of your life? Because if it isn't something that you and your family usually do, you're definitely not alone. It's a really hard thing to get a healthy habit going of reading the Bible together with your family in your house. And it's especially hard if we don't know where to get started with something like that. But don't worry, because it's never too late to start a new habit, and especially a good one like reading the Bible. So today what I want to do is I want to tell you guys about a really nifty tool, a really helpful tool that can help you personally or you and your family to read the Bible at home. And it's an app called the WELS app. And you can find it on your phone or on any of your devices at WELS.APP, WELS app. When you get there, there's a button here right in the top middle of your screen that says add to home screen. And you can click on that, or mom and dad can click on it to add it to the home screen of your device. And then it'll be there every single time you start up your device, so you can always come back. Now there's four really cool things that I want to show you about this app. The first one, there's just a verse of the day, a new verse every single day. The second one is this daily devotion. So when you click on that, it takes you to this devotion where, once again, there's a new Bible passage every day, and then a short little devotion, and finally, a prayer. And this is really great that you guys could read through this when you get up in the morning, or have mom or dad read it to you. You could look at it together at dinner time, or even right before you go to bed. And there's another one too called the family devotion, and this is actually my favorite. It looks a lot the same as the daily devotion. First there's a Bible passage, and then a short little devotion. But what's even cooler about this one, friends, is it's written for you guys. It's written for kids. And after the closing prayer, there's even questions here that you can go through by yourself, or you could go through with your mom or dad. There's questions for our preschool friends, for our elementary school friends, and also for our middle school friends. And then finally, every time that they have a new one, there's a verse of a song here. Now, these don't come out every day. The family devotion, they come out with a new one every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So there's still three of them that come out every single week, and that can be a really awesome tool. Then the last part that I want to tell you guys about, and this might be especially useful for our older friends here at school, or for moms and dads if you want something a little bit more, it's called Through My Bible. And when you go to that section, what you're going to find is a little bit longer passage from the Bible. And that's all it is here, is just reading through a part of the Bible. And if you do this every single day, what it's going to do is it's going to take you entirely all the way through the Bible in just 3 years. And so in 3 years of going through this once a day for just maybe 3 or 4 minutes, you'll get to read through the entire Bible. And then the one thing that I haven't mentioned yet, friends, is that for every single one of these, you can read through it, or there's also an option to just hit play and listen to it on a recording. It'll read through the whole thing for you. So that's really an awesome tool. And there are so many other ones too. If you want more ideas of ways that you can study the Bible at home with your family, feel free to talk to me or talk to one of your teachers, and we can help you guys find a way to get reading the Bible to become something that you do at home with mom or dad. So when you go home today, friends, talk to your parents or your grandparents and ask them if you can start reading the Bible together as a family. Ask them if maybe you could get this app on your phone or on an iPad so that you can look at these devotions together as a family and start making a practice of reading God's word often. Because when we do that, God's going to help us to hide his word away into our hearts, to secure it there, to keep us pure and to keep us from sin. By keeping us from sinning, but most importantly, by reminding us that when we do sin, we have forgiveness through Jesus, because the blood of Jesus washes all of our sins away. Friends, will you say a prayer with me? Jesus, we thank you so much for your word. And we ask that you would help us to read it and learn from it every day, to seek you out in it. Help us with our families to develop a habit of reading your word, so that we can grow closer to you every day. Amen. Let's go ahead now, friends, and join together in those three identity questions that tell us about who we are through Jesus. I'll say the question, and then I want to invite you to go ahead and join in saying the answers with me. Who are you? I am a child of God, an heir of eternity, loved and saved through Jesus. And what are you called to do? I am called to be a disciple of Jesus, with him living in me, so that I can live for him. How can you live for Jesus? with the power and forgiveness of Jesus, I can be a leader by serving God and others. And now, friends, let's join together in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. Just two really quick announcements, friends. Please, first of all, remember that this is the end of our first term, so it's our last chance if we want to donate some money to our first term mission monies designation, which is the Lighthouse Youth Center. If you want to bring in some money to help support the Lighthouse, you can bring it in this next week and give it to your teacher. If you're at home, you can bring it into the next packet pickup. And then finally, please come in and join us for worship here this weekend, next weekend, any weekend here at Mount Lebanon. We're here on Saturdays at 5:30. We're here at Sundays at 9:30 in the morning, and we'd love to see you and your family there. Let's join together now in singing our closing worship song, Crown Him with Many Crowns. God bless your week.